ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we have just completed 2/3 of the beautiful month of Ramadan. And we know the purpose of Ramadan is for us to gain taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Ramadan in 5 verses in the whole Mus'haf. In the whole Qur'an, only talks about it once in Surah Al-Baqarah. And he begins by saying, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا O you who believe, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. The meaning of taqwa, we must look at it as a concept and not as a term, which goes into 3. The highest meaning of taqwa, manzilatul muraqabah, to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees you at all times. وَهُوَ الْإِحْسَانُ تَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ فَإِنْ لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاكَ. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you see Him, and if you cannot, فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاكَ. But know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees you. وَالْإِحْسَانُ as well, as we said, is to do more than you are ordered to do, than you are obligated to do. كَانُوا قَلِيلًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا يَهْجَعُونَ. You guys are praying Taraweeh, may Allah accept from all of us. وَبِالْأَسْحَارِ هُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. Doing daily istighfar. وَفِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌّ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ. What better time to practice this meaning of taqwa than the month of Ramadan? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the one who is fasting from the one who is not fasting. ولهذا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كل عمل ابن آدم له إلا الصوم فإنه لي وأنا أجزي به. Everything the son of Adam does is for him, except when he fasts. That act of worship is for me, and I will reward him for it on the day of judgment. And only he knows if we are fasting. The second meaning of a taqwa is to stay away from the haram, staying away from the sins. جاء رجل إلى أبو هريرة and he said, ما التقوى يا أبو هريرة؟ What is a taqwa? And he answered the question with a question. And he said, هل مشيت على طريق فيه شوك؟ Did you ever walk on a road where there are thorns? قال نعم. So he told him, how did you walk on a road full of thorns? He said, اتقيته. اتقيته بمعنى I stayed away from the thorns and I protected myself from the thorns. What did Abu Hurairah say? He said, هذا هو التقوى. This is taqwa. Imagine the thorns being sins, whether small, whether big. We as Muslims try to stay away from the sins as much as possible, especially during this time of the month of Ramadan. And last but not least, the meaning that Talq ibn Habib tells us, أن تعمل بطاعة الله على نور من الله ترجو ثواب الله. To act upon the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if there are times you feel like it is difficult, but never say anything is impossible. Always say, I can, or I will change, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you change towards the good. عَلَى نُورٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ, only through what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains to you and orders you to do, and not something that you create out of your own mental thought, as we know as bid'ah. تَرْجُوا ثَوَابَ اللَّهِ, you seek the أجر from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَن تَتْرُكَ مَعْصِيَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَى نُورٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ تَخَافُ عِقَابَ اللَّهِ. And to leave these sins that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed for us, has told us and talked about in the Quran and Sunnah, عَلَى نُورٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ, same meaning, that only the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to do it, and not through any creation of your own, through bid'ah, out of fear of the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a taqwa. And when you look in the verses, right after the verse of a taqwa and the purpose of Ramadan, he reminds us, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. He did not say fasting right away, and he talked about food and how we should fast, leaving food and leaving drinking. No, he says, this is the month where the Qur'an, the holy book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, was brought down to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when you look at the story of Prophet Adam, when he was brought down from the Jannah to earth, he would always tell him, فَإِمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُم مِّنِّي هُدَى فَمَنْ تَبِعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا يَضِلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى. And once my guidance comes to you, O Adam, and your people, and you follow this guidance, you will be led to the straight path, and you will never be led astray. What was this guidance? شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس. A guidance to all people. ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explains the Qur'an as حَبْلُ اللَّهِ الْمَتِينَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ. It is a strong rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the heavens down to the earth. And this is why we're told, as the Sahaba used to say, the verse وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. It's telling us, reminding us, to not forget the Qur'an. He's telling you this is a month of hope. That even if you are a person who's falling in sins, even if you are a person who is in the darkness of all darkness, there is still a guidance for you to be led back to the straight path. And once you are led to the straight path, it keeps you steadfast upon your deen. قُلْ نَزَّلَهُ رُوحُ الْقُدُسِ مِنْ رَبِّكَ بِالْحَقِّ لِيُثَبِّتَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, to keep those true believers steadfast upon their belief, upon La ilaha illallah. And once this takes place, the Qur'an, the effect of the Qur'an on your life is amazing. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in khutbat al-wada', he said, تَرَكْتُ فِيكُمْ مَا إِن تَمَسَّكْتُمْ بِهِمَا لَن تَضِلُّ مِن بَعْدِ أَبَدًا. I have left with you two things that if you hold on to, you will never go astray. كتاب الله وسنتي. The book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and my sunnah. The ahadith. True guidance for all of human mankind. And then what? The effects of it after you're guided and you're kept steadfast upon your deen. وننزل من القرآن ما هو شفاء ورحمة للمؤمنين. The Qur'an, what came with it? Healing, shifa', especially for the nafs. When the nafs is dying, what revives it? The Qur'an. And mercy to the believers. وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, سَبْعَةٌ يُظِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظِلِّهِ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلُّهُ. And one of the people he explained were who? رجل ذكر الله خاليا ففاضت عيناه. A person who remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he is alone, that his eyes begin to tear. When was the last time you remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You listened to the Qur'an, you were praying by yourself at night, and your eyes began to tear out of love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask yourself this question. Ask yourself, this should be a month of change for you. And the first sign to me that I believe is a beautiful sign is when you let your eyes tear out of love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah says, مَا رَأَيْتُ شَيْئًا يَهُذُّ الْعَقْلَ وَالْرُوحِ. I have never seen anything that nourishes the mind and the heart. يَصِحُّ الْجَسَدِ, and always keeps the body healthy. وَيَضْمَنُ السَّعَادَةِ عَلَى وَجْهِ الْأَرْضِ مِثْلَ مَا يَضْمَنُهُ الْقُرْآنِ لِمَنْ مَتَّعَ بِالنَّظَرِ فِيهِ. And guarantees happiness for the person in on earth, like I have seen the Qur'an guarantee happiness and all of the things he explained to the one who reads the Qur'an. This is the beauty of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi ikhwa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains the rijal, and each and every single one of us calls himself a rajul. The true man, the true believer is who? رجال لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة. Who, when they're doing business, any kind of business, it never distracts them from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi ikhwa, there is a person, one of the most famous influential people, especially in the Middle Eastern world. He tells you he became paralyzed in his right side of the body. And he went to the doctor, and the doctor was a Jewish, Yahudi. And he told him, you're going to have to live your life by this. And before he's leaving, he tells him, Inta Muslim? Are you Muslim? Doctor Yahudi, huh? A doctor is Jewish. He's saying, are you Muslim? He said, yes. He said, عَلَيْكَ بِالْقُرْآنِ عَلَيْكَ بِالْقُرْآنِ. 3 months before he got interviewed, he was paralyzed. When it came to the interview, he said, I never left the Qur'an one day in my life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him full shifa. And he became a regular, walking, moving human being. And he said, this is the barakah of the Qur'an. Ya ikhwa, start small. In this month, this beautiful month, start small. Don't go too big. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ. Never underestimate how small or how big the hasana is, and never underestimate how small and how big the sayyi'ah can be for you. And as we move on, we're going to see the next verse بإذن الله تعالى. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. Moving on after this beautiful verse that talks about the month of Ramadan in the Quran, and then one of the most beautiful verses in the whole Quran that many of us only look at the first statement but do not look at the ayah fully itself. وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب. Say, O Muhammad, if my servants ask you about me, فإني قريب. The conversation begins between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Mid-ayah, the conversation becomes between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and directly the servant. He says, فإني قريب. Then I am close. Indeed, I am close. أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان. I respond to the call of the one who is calling me. Once he calls me, إذا دعان, if he calls me. الدُّعَاء is a conversation between you towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والقرآن is a conversation between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala towards the human beings and the Muslims. And this is why in the next part of the ayah it says, فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. So they respond to me and they believe in me so that they may be on the straight path. What is he telling you? What does he mean by saying you respond to me? He means he's telling you respond to the calls of the Qur'an. When it tells you pray, you pray. When it tells you give zakah, you give zakah. When it tells you fast Ramadan, you fast Ramadan. وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي, and they believe in me. And when you look at the description of the believers, صِفَاتُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ in Surah Al-Mu'minun, in the first 11 verses, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the Sahaba when these verses were revealed to him, whoever takes care of these verses, Jannah is guaranteed for him. And that's why in the end of these 11 verses it says, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْوَارِثُونَ الَّذِينَ يَرِثُونَ الْفِرْدَوْسَ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. What are the description of the believers? قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. The mu'mineen, the believers are successful. How? الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. They have khushu' in their prayer. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ. And they speak nothing but good speech. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ. They take care of their zakah and their sadaqah at all times. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ. And they take care of their private area. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَعَهْدِهِمْ رَاعُونَ. They take care of their amanat. They don't sleep until they know that they have nothing between them and someone else. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَوَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. And then what? They take care of their prayer. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْوَارِثُونَ الَّذِينَ يَرِثُونَ الْفِرْدَوْسَ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. Those are the inheritors. What do they inherit? Jannah. And they will be there for eternity. If you look at the verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about salah twice. Twice. And everything else he reminds us once about. Salah, the most important act of worship in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أول ما يحاسب به العبد يوم القيامة الصلاة فإن صلحت صلح سائر عمله. وَإِنْ فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ سَائِرُ عَمَلِهِ. The first thing you will be asked about on the Day of Judgment is your salah. If it is good, if you took care of your salah, then all of your righteous actions and your deeds will be accepted. And if not, وَلْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, then all of your actions, all of your righteous deeds will go to waste. وَلِهَذَا يَا إِخْوَةَ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the salah, when you begin to change yourself in Ramadan, you start with the fara'id. You don't start with the nawafil or the sunnah. مَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا افْتَرَضْتُهُ عَلَيْهِ. My servant did not come close to me except with the things that I love the most, which are the things I made obligatory on him. يا إخوة صلاة الفجر صلاة العصر, all the salawat in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are beautiful, are amazing. He reminds you to pray them. But when you look at Salat al-Fajr, the most difficult prayer of all, the most difficult prayer of all, no doubt about it, to the point where the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إنكم سترون ربكم كما ترون القمر ليلة البدر لا تضامون في رؤيته. You will see your Lord. سترون ربكم just like you see the moon on that night where the moon is full, ليلة البدر. No one can deny it. فإن استطعتم ألا تغلبوا على صلاة قبل طلوع الشمس وصلاة قبل غروبها فافعلوا. Then if you cannot be defeated, beaten by Shaytan for salawat before the salah, before the rise of the sun and a salah before the sun sets, then do. He tells us if people knew the benefit of praying salat al-fajr in the masjid, they would have came even if they had to crawl. This is why the masajid are here. People out of pure laziness, they say, what? I have to go in my car to the masjid to pray and then come back home. I'll pray at home. And then what? We want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us. We want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us victory. Ya ikhwah, it is unbelievable to want something from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who created you, who gave you your feet, who gave you your limbs, who gave you everything, who gave you the opportunity to fast Ramadan, but out of pure laziness, at the end of Ramadan, after Ramadan, there is no change. The number of people in the masajid is not changing. As we said, the hadith of the people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put them under His shade. One of them was, who else? رجل قلبه معلق بالمساجد. His heart is connected to the masajid. Wallahi, I came here as a visitor. The masjid is opened brand new. 20 nights. Dhuhr and Asr. We do not see anybody. Wallahi, we do not see anybody. It is a shame. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, we want the victory. Ya ikhwa, I'm from Syria. Family, people have been killed. They want the victory from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But they don't want to worship Him. They don't want to respect Him. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. A shart. Condition that you worship Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then He will give you victory. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised the Muslims victory. But you have to worship Him. وَعَدَ اللَّهُ لَا يُخْلِفُ اللَّهُ وَعَدَ. He will never, never act other than upon His promise. But where are the Muslims? Where is the rijal? Ugh, wallahi, it is a shame. It is a shame to see this happening. And this is why when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was on the minbar and he said Ameen three times and then he said Ja'a Jibreel ilay faqal ya Muhammad man adraka Ramadan wa lam yughfar lah fa'ab'alahu Allah qultu Ameen. The best of angels is making dua and the best of humans is saying Ameen to the dua. He said, whoever Ramadan comes upon him, he has the ability to live life through Ramadan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not forgive him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep him away from His mercy. This is Jibreel, the best of angels making dua. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying Ameen to the dua. حَاسِبُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ قَبْلَ أَن تُحَاسَبُوا. Self-evaluate yourself. Before the day of judgment, you're going to get asked. The people of the hellfire, when they ask, when they get asked, مَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي سَقَرْ, the first thing they say, قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ. We were those who neglected our prayers. We must revive ourselves, especially with the salawat, the fara'id of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Connect yourself with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What are you waiting for? No one knows when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take your soul. والله يا أخي, a story, a sheikh says, a person who always took care of the salat. And when they brought his body, when he passed away, he washed his body and they took him to the burial. And once they removed the cloth from his face, he saw his face smiling. He said, I have never seen a face with much nur as I've seen this face. He said, Wallahi law ma ghasaltu lama araftu annahu qad mat. If I did not wash him, I would have never knew that he died. This is a salah. This is the worship that we neglect, unfortunately. ثَلَاثُ آيَاتٍ نَزَلَتْ مَقْرُونَةً بِثَلَاثٍ. Three verses, they came together. وَأَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ. Number one, worship Allah, be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Prophet. أَنِشْكُرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيْكَ. To thank me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying this, and to thank your parents. And what? أَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُ الزَّكَاةَ. أَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ. Wallahi, ya ikhwa, it's something we are forgetting about. And when you forget about, it opens the door to the shahawat and the sins. فَخَلَفَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ خَلْفٌ أَضَاعُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَاتَّبَعُوا الشَّهَوَاتِ. They neglect the prayer, and then the door of shahawat is open right away. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يَا جِبْرِيلُ تُضَيِّعُ أُمَّةِ الصَّلَاةِ. My ummah is neglecting the prayer. The salah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made obligatory on them. What did Jibreel say? Ya Muhammad, يَأْتِي أَقْوَامًا مِنْ أُمَّتِكَ يَبِيعُونَ دِينَهُمْ كُلَّهِ بِعَرَضٍ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا قَلِيلٍ. There will come people from your ummah, O Muhammad, that will sell their deen just for some little happiness in this dunya. Ask yourself, are you changing? Have you changed? This is the month of hope. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you that guidance is coming down from the heavens down to us. We just have to hold on to that guidance. We must connect ourselves with the Quran, which is dusted. Never think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us anything, from victory to anything, if we do not respect Him. How can you say, Ya Rabb, انظر الإسلام والمسلمين, but you disrespect Him? How can? When you are so into this dunya. Wallahi, some of the youth who our ummah is depending on, إِذَا أَرَدْتَ أَن تَعْرِفَ مُسْتَقْبَلَ هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ فَانْظُرْ إِلَى شَبَابِ الْأُمَّةِ. If you want to know the future of this ummah, look at the shabab, look at the youth of this ummah. This is why we get ordered, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاصْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهِ. Order your family to pray, وَاصْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهِ, and then you be steadfast upon what you call upon. أتأمرون الناس بالبر. You call people to do good and then you forget yourselves. وأنتم تتلون الكتاب. And you know the ayat and you read the verse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a time, especially in the last 10 nights, where we have to look at ourselves and ask ourselves the same question. Have we changed? Is our connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala better? Or is it the same before Ramadan even came upon us? Is it? Ask yourself. حَاسِبُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Wallahi, I'm going to keep on saying this. قَبْلَ أَن تُحَاسَبُ. Evaluate yourself before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you on the Day of Judgment why you neglected your salah. Why you left the Qur'an? Wallahi, the masajid, ya ikhwa, they're open just for you. They're open just for the Muslims. And the people who will keep it open and running are the Muslims. I tell you, ashhadu billah, uqsimu billah, I've been here as a visitor coming from another state. And I've seen the effect of it in other states, but I have never seen anything like this. To the point where if I was not here and one other person was not here with me, sleeping here, then no one would be here in Dhuhr or Asr. Unfortunately, it is a shame. And it is my duty to call and remind you to come to the masajid. But you are the only person that can fix yourself. إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتْ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءَ. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can guide you. That's if you want to be guided. Especially that condition, if you as a Muslim, say, Ah, Ya Allah, Ya Rabb, help me. أَكْثِرُ مِنَ الدُّعَاءِ. In this last 10 nights, Allahu a'lam when Laylat al-Qadr will come. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability to be and to be able to live that night. But make dua, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that when he was reminding us about a dua to say in the last 10 nights, he said, say, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anna. Say ameen. He said, say this dua as much as possible in the last 10 nights. Laylatul Qadri khayrun min alfi shahr. Imagine this. But if we are not changing, imagine the dua of Jibreel. Imagine this dua. Ask yourself, are you changing? Is your connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala better? Do you think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins after this month? Because if not, then I do not know what to tell you anymore. If you cannot change yourself in the month of Ramadan, then when can you change yourself? This has to end. We have to change. We have to become better Muslims. Otherwise, everything happening around us from trials and tests will never end. Because the only purpose of these trials and tests is for us to change towards better. الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. To see the ones who will do better towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us change towards good. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us in this beautiful month of Ramadan. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
استوعت الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. إذا زلزلت الأرض زلزالها وأخرجت الأرض أثقالها وقال الإنسان ما لها يومئذ تحدث أخبارها بأن ربك أوحى لها يومئذ يصدر الناس أشتاتا ليروا أعمالهم فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره الله. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر الله. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله